something once again about Voyage. And I'm going to try to write this presentation by showing you some examples of this. That's why I call it the complete, because it's what I want to do as focus of this presentation. But I want to start a little bit here. This is me. And I want to stop here because this time I come to Esther, there is someone who I already talked with him. I went to drink with him, and he said, "Hello," like looking at me, like, "Who are you?" Okay, this is me. And this is well, this analysis around Voyage. Voyage is now around a couple of years with some success. I already talked about it 2 years ago, and I did a tutorial around Voyage and Mondo-Page driver last year. I thought it was necessary to keep pushing because I was very and I have seen a lot of people who are actually not using Voyage that they could. And they are not using it because they assume that Voyage cannot do something for us to be used in a specific way or whatever. They assume that they cannot make it fit to their needs, and I want to demonstrate that it is possible. So, also I want to state this persistent tendency of the community of inventory of one game, We have a thing, let's improve it. So, that's the reason. For those who doesn't know what this is, Voyage is a simple session layer to map objects into a database. It's the equivalent of an object relational mapper with the difference that we do not target relational database. We target NoSQL database mainly. That in theory is an approach that can be used also for targeting relational databases. The problem is that one of the first reference I made was with Glow, and it didn't look like really useful because Glow is a very advanced system. It's like putting another layer of suppression in terms of what is something that is very complicated. And okay, it simplified a little bit my life, but it was the effort to make it work was not working. But it is possible. And it was also a simple approach using image segments back when Pharo had this image segment. And I used it for a couple of small projects. And it was working also, and it worked. But basically, now it just has an approach to persist in memory, which is used in my case, I don't think anyone has used for that yet, but for deploying just from databases, because it's basically a way of providing access to the objects that you already have in a graph, but it's an integrated process. And the most used, the most used of the technologies so today is to Mongo databases, to the materials that used in the Mongo database. It's a really simple approach. We are not targeting things like NoSQL language or things complicated like that, abstractions that can abstract to the real complexity of sometimes part of the functionality of the database that we target. We just try to approach like that, use a pattern, a way of using the persistence in a real context. So we have just like 8 methods that we find for the one of the only points of using database is that if you do a report and they provide you an object, and then to do another request and to send you another object that I just could represent exactly the same entry in the database, but you really have to have different stuff, and that's what is called the identity, problem. And of course, any different framework for the database has to implement a solution for that, and we obviously do. So, the last one is handling. This could be included in our opinion, and it's like that. And of course, it provides a connection pool so we can use it in the environment. We have different strategies of for plugin, and we have also a strategy for plugin into a C-side session, so we can have a different repository for each application, for each session, so it is useful when you want to run different applications inside one. My side, my side, my video, story, side, and several things that one image is just going to not be, and it's difficult to have this computer for us, so that's okay, and then we can use this as a first. So, this is complete the first of the time, which is disable complete, instead of providing a framework like you, use the framework to ask objects, or you use the framework to that it just provides a set of methods in objects where you can that you can use for setting the objects from the database, so you move. The advantage of that is that you can override those methods and provide the behavior that you want to put validations on the server. You can put a lot of things that otherwise is complicated, and you can Mongo has a query language, and the way to query that is just to pass it the query language that is Mongo, it's not translating anything. And if you use the in-memory approach, you just want to pass a block, a common block. But we do not provide again the common instruction. So, and we have which is to be the drive of NoSQL database. So we can have both words properly tracking. So, what's the problem that we want to solve with this? And it's a basic interactive problem. Everybody who works with databases already knows this. The problem is that there is a difference between your object class and what you put in a database. In the ideal world, they propose you to do something like this. You must run an object to a database and then you have certain rules. But really, the reality is that you have an object model, something like this, which is more complicated, and I have an error in a project form because I wrote it in Spanish. But okay, right. It will really help. This is similar to the kind of object model that we have, but it's not true. Because the thing that happens is that we usually keep in a collection of buildings that are but we have different kinds of objects inside a collection. How do you map that into a relational database? The limit is really complicated. I'm trying to design to make the theorem for the that for putting in this presentation explain that, but I don't know that since we do more problems that we are going to do. So, and even something like this. That's the structure of a real small talk program, not a bunch of papers. And nothing that is like running like a news twice the tables and a lot of. Of course, with a NoSQL, with a document database, you don't need that. So, what are the steps of using this? The first is just as simple as this. The problem is that most of the people that are used to use relational databases are not thinking objects, are thinking table objects. I'm thinking with how this model is completely inconsistent. It's how this model will fit into our database, a relational database, of course. And we need to get rid of that problem. For us, I'm going to do something demo. Yes, this is, you can see it? Okay, this is how we install Voyage, and this is how you create a repository. The first method is connecting to a database with Mastara, and and the enable syncing from messages is going to configure the repository to be used as a unique entrance for the loop. So, just put that, execute that, and then we have several let's present a little bit the model. I have a Pharo, and here I have Pharo. So, here, anybody who plays for 10 days knows that also here have a level so that they can know what I'm asking. Now, not a good. It's a name of power, a power, and not a good. And power, of course, has the name, and I just added a list of zeros for actually have that power. Basically, it's a cycle server. I could use the row data. So, the sentence for the database is empty and drop it. And to create and save one, you just need to do this. And that is, and this is going to create, instead of execute, it's going to create here. A couple of collections already with course in detail you see. The other is a lot with certain metadata that we added. That is needed for after reconstruction. Of course, as you can see, we have the name and the power is actually pointing to another collection. Actually pointing to another collection and describing the kind of instance. Because we can have here at the collection. So, if we take a look at power, we have a with the reference back. So, what else has already been said of this? This is an improvement on RMoD because it's like our implementation of currency. Of course, Mongo does not have by itself. This is the only way we can implement this, and it is working pretty fine. So, next, take control of your graph. As you see, we generate a graph that has a lot of metadata and has a lot of assumptions. And that's because Mongo knows the type of the attributes that we are persisting, and Pharo knows the type of the objects that we need. It's really easy to insert all the data, and then we can insert almost everything. But most commonly, we will not that, for example, they will need to bring in the data there, they can do a keyboard, things like that. For doing that, Voyage uses magnetic to describe the object. But it uses magnetic in a different way that it's used. Magnetic is usually used in a declarative way, and you have to declare everything that it is. That is that everything of the object. And that is needed because it's usually used for user interfaces, which are very limited. But sometimes there is a magnetic. There is a magnet here, mapping, and then you need to see all your fields because they don't map, do not map exactly to something that you want. Okay. We use an inference magnet description, which is basically inserts everything, but you can actually condition it. So you condition it, you have, for example, container, when you can change the collection name. Let's try in the collection what is going to go. You have the power where you can, for example, say the type of the collection. Why? Because you say Mongo does not have a state or an order collection or whatever, and you might want to bring the object in that way. Mongo just gives you an array. You might want to construct it in. You can have a strategy for changing what is a name in the database. Of course, collection set in a lazy way, but if you want it in a clear way, because you know it's really not so easy and the information to be used, so it's faster to set it directly. You can also you can also change the behavior of the one-to-one reference description. You have several options. And of course, there are too many. And the other side, you do the same. You can change all your values. And of course, I spend a little bit more for doing something more fun in the database because here you have some improvement that has been to keep your database. So, you have a container, for example, a pocket of a laptop, and from some of them, the one I want to use. I was here, he wasn't actually any power. I'm not sure he's either, but he's a good guy. And he has a good guy. So, if we do more or less the same now, I'll drop the letter that I start. And we test it here. And now we have. Of collection and no power collection. Right? I don't need power. So, if we check here, we can do it perfectly. So, next. There is one. Particular problem with Voyage is that integrity, Mongo does not have any tool for, it doesn't have a guarantee for anything, but that it doesn't have any tool to guarantee integrity of it. And since we have a graph for references to a lot of things, we actually cannot in this version know, for example, when you remove some object, some root that is also referenced by another root. So what we do there this code, can make sense to this collection that it will allow new things like that. So when you access to the object code, you have a missing reference, you just want to replace it by a new in the next time. So it's a consequence. It's also going to happen in the user, but it doesn't happen automatically. And that, of course, is dangerous. If it's dangerous, allowing missing content properties is something that you have to choose by yourself and just by default, you will have an error of you should know that anyway, if you have several